lovely, beautifully quiet in here. I guess that's what happens when we're socially distanced and can't talk so much to our neighbour, but it's really setting the scene for this extraordinary class, which I know is going to be really special today. I'm absolutely delighted to welcome back to the RCM Sir András Schiff, who has been with us a couple of times before, and of course recently was with us when he was awarded an honorary doctorate by Prince Charles. And we're really very, very lucky indeed that he's found time in his schedule to come back and work with three of our students this evening. For today's class, we've chosen three senior students who are all on the college's postgraduate Artist Diploma course, all of whom have distinguished themselves throughout their time here. They've been contributing to the life of the college as artistic role models, and they will be working on Beethoven's visionary last three sonatas, Opus 109, 110, and 111, which is, of course, as you all know, some of the most demanding music in the piano repertoire. So the first to the stage will be Victor, who's going to play Opus 109, it's Maslov. We'll welcome him, and of course welcome Sir András very warmly. Thank you very much for joining us, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. you very much. Does this work? Probably not. Can you hear me? No, very good, very excellent. Молодец.
Thank you.
Ну, поздравляю вам.
Спасибо.
Very beautiful. I have very little to say, but I have to say something. That's why we are here, no? In the first movement, I missed the vivace. So where is the vivace for you? So it's very beautiful, but somehow, first of all, I missed the vivace. And secondly, I couldn't understand that it starts with an upbeat, yes? Mm-hmm. If I didn't know the piece, just listening to you, it started like 1, 2, 1, 2, instead of 2, 1, 2, 1. Not too soon. This is excellent. So the tempo relationships are very good. How you do it? Most people don't get this. But it's very good with you because it's a 2-to-1 relationship. So that's very good. Now play the development section from here. Exactly what he writes, dynamics, you see? Crescendo, but how far does a crescendo go? And then go back. It's not a huge crescendo, maybe from piano to mezzo piano, and then always back, yeah? Sunday within piano. I'm sorry, I would love to let you play more, but we have to go through 3 sonatas, so I apologize. Yes? Now just do the coda from here. That you are listening, very good voicing, yes? It's very difficult. One more time. Hesitation, C natural, C sharp. Which way are we going? So just make a little more of that from the coda, yes? Less. Fine in a room. You have to, this is something you have to learn in life. How do you play in a larger hall, more reverberant? So listen to yourself. Your tempo for this acoustics is too fast. I know it's prestissimo, but already from the first row, I couldn't hear the details, and that's a pity. So just play 5% less. Shouldn't come near you, sorry. When he writes legato for those two bars, that means that the two previous bars are not so legato. And with you, I don't hear the difference. Than cello, and pianissimo misterioso. Yes. see the acoustics. But it has to have a pulse. You have to see, because where is the una corda coming, yes? This is not ad libitum. So it has to have a new color. Okay, go from here. This one more time, because when Beethoven goes into larger note values, so it's composed, you don't have to play slower. Mm-hmm. 6/8, yes. Pedal, everything. Yes, yam pam pam pim pirari ya da dam. Yeah, just do that. Tenuto. And now continue. Adagio, andantes, walking, so it's a sarabande. So you try to find the right tempo. gesangvoll, so sing. And if you would think of the first bar as an upbeat to the second bar, it goes to the second bar, to the fourth bar, and that will help you to make, to put it together. I also like it on the beat, but one should understand which is the main note. This. And so this is not too important. Crescendo, subito piano. This arpeggio before the note. Otherwise, you confuse us a little bit, time wise. Is too flowing for you, or you have to get used to it, but I would like you to just to think about it in your dream. Yeah, because it's andante. So now first variation, very Italian. Italian opera, so play the orchestra, the the second and the third beats are too heavy. On the beat, an Italian singer doesn't think about that. Because because it it's a little pedantic. We don't, just the second half, please. It's very special. No? All right. But it's very, very, very beautiful now. Now, do the next one like mosaic. Yeah? Little notes, but not too short. That's too short. Yes. So where is the theme here? Yeah, so you have to suggest a little, that's too much, but you know. Here there is no theme. Just in the back of your mind, you don't have to show it to the audience. It's none of their business. Always concentrate on this falling third. Kinds of trills. This should not be a nervous trill. Enthusiastic. A little agitato. Let's just go on to the next one because this is the same. Speed limit. You are over the speed limit. For this hall, maybe not somewhere else. Everything, and this is non legato. Mm-hmm. little more of a transition. And just a little bit slower than the theme. This quality, it's beautiful. This variation, you could improvise a little more, as if it were by Schumann.
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, just go from here. Not so direct. Pom pom. These four zandi are agogics, yeah? Say less pedal, but not here. Maybe just put a half pedal because. This is like Michelangelo, sculpture with a hammer and on a piece of marble. It's like out of Missa Solemnis. Credo, credo, credo. The eighth bar. This needs time. You need an acoustic comma, yes? Again, the transition, but just a little, you have to yield, but not twice as slow. Because we have again dim pa dim pa di dom dim pam. What was a minim in the fifth variation becomes a crotchet here. Every other note softer. Yeah? This is the climax, yes? And from just along that, taka taka taka, all notes are equal, and some notes are more equal than others. Just that. Again, you are taka taka taka. All the we had in. Thirds. Together, hear me from there. And it's very good with the pedal that you let it float a little. Just try to play one last time, like remembering, yes? And as simple as possible. It's a little bit fussy. Semplice. Too much is by me. Just a little less. The idea is good, but it's too much. let's go in. Most things are in the last movement, but let's go from the beginning. So, like in the 109, we had this. Now we have the. Concentrate on those intervals, yes? And start like a string quartet. Arioso starts, listen to the long notes. When we play the piano, it always makes a diminuendo, but we have to make the illusion of a long note, like a singer. Left hand plays in tempo. Yes? Very good. Excellent. Yes? Now continue when you get to the 32nd notes. Can you play it with one hand? And all the little notes with the wedge, little more melodic, yes? Very good. You see, it's another story. So one more time.
Can I ask?
Yeah.
What would be better to play right hand only or with left hand?
Right hand.
On the right.
Yeah. Here, yes. Then when it comes in E major,
yes.
Then it's different. Then you can change hands.
Okay.
But here, it's sometimes with Beethoven, he doesn't want it to be too easy.
Last time the same.
Last time the same. All right. No, that's very good. That's all I wanted. No. Let's just play from here, please. Is not necessary. No? Expression is very good, but it's over the top or from the trill. Yeah. should play it. So emphasize the asymmetrical parts of the left hand. Yes? Legatissimo. And not it. Like glued to the keys. Very good. Отлично, да? Так. Very good. That's all. Here, now the development section, please observe when one bar is non-crescendo and one is with hairpins. There has to be more difference, yes? Nothing. Big, good, good. Niente. And now it turns around, yes? All right. Now that's very good. Just play the end of the movement, which is this apotheosis. From there. Huh? The middle voice, it foreshadows the fugue, yes? So here, watch the balance. Left hand is a little too heavy. Yeah? Немножко, чуть-чуть. Your gravity. This is too percussive. Fifth finger, yeah? Not too fast, again, what I said in the other sonata. You know, these are folk songs.
Yes.
Народная песня, да? Unser Katz hat Gittchen gehabt. So for each note, you have a word. Separate. Yep. cadence. Mm-hmm. The subdominant, dominant tonic. Yeah. Funny, yeah? It's a very interesting sonata because every movement is so different. First is very lyrical, this is a funny movement, and then comes something metaphysical. But so, yeah? Cheeky. Asking to you, please, no, no, yeah? Deny. Just play these notes, see? I don't hear the pronunciation. Okay, and now, it's very good, but it's too easy for you. Because he played slow. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. So it's ambiguous, yes? Just play the right hand alone. You know what I mean? Play it a little jazzy. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry. No, it's very good. You are doing excellent. So go on. Yeah, but then subito fortissimo, papi, and then again piano. He writes. No, that's all right. So this you still have to practice and tito 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 tito. This is very funny.
Yes, and it's hard.
Very hard.
Play funny, you.
Yeah, but don't worry about the accuracy. That you are very accurate anyway. Yeah. All right. Now. So that's about what I have to say about this movement. We could go on, but now let's go from No. Now you have to think about the tempo relationship. Yeah? Adagio ma non troppo. And then you will have real adagio. So feel the quavers in your heart. The rhythm double dotting. pulse. Tranquillo, but the heart is beating. Da capo. A recitative, no? So speaking, like in an opera. So then the orchestra comes in, yes? So separate those passages with singer alone, and then the orchestra comes. Arpeggio. Change the pedal too soon, because Beethoven is a real revolutionary with the pedal. No one has ever thought of this before. So he wants this to be blurred. Yeah? Not too soon, actually. I'm not even sure one should come out here. Everyone has to come. No? But not so loud. It's piano, no? Piano crescendo, yes? And that tempo, yes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. One more time. This is difficult. This fingering of, you are doing it, but the second note, it's tied, yeah? And still 4-3, 4-3, so correct, you have to play the second time also the note. Almost inaudible, but there, yeah? And just show me this a few times, this 4-3. Mm-hmm. No, but I still have to question you, I'm sorry. It's very good. Now, so...
I'd like to slow.
Yes. Well, I don't like to use these words slow or fast or... loud or soft, but adagio ma non troppo. But do this one more time and also observe where Beethoven wants una corda and tutte le corde. So. Have you played a piano from Beethoven's time? An old piano, you should have this. I'm sure you have instruments from it. Because the difference between una corda and two or three strings is enormous. On a modern piano, it's almost inaudible. But if once you have that experience with the old piano, you will never forget it. Yes? So, anyway, go from here. This is about death. La morte. Yes? All right. So I don't want to disturb it. It should stay so beautiful. But play the accompaniment. Now this is like in a requiem. So the trombones muted trombones. Just play the accompaniment and that should be steady and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, pom 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 pim pom pom. But you are still playing pom 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 instead of one pom pom, 1, 2, 3, okay. 1, 2, 3, one, yes? You see, then you have a sense of a movement, yes?
But without third beat, only first beat.
Yes, and not mechanical, just think, yes, think yes. In groups of three,
yes, like
because you are playing 12 notes. And I just want 4 times 3 notes. Of Bach, St. John Passion, es ist vollbracht, consummatum est, you know, so it's the last word of Christ. And this is autobiographical sonata. He was very ill here, so, yeah, his own life. Yeah. All right, so just when you think, try to sing this. Es ist vollbracht. That gives you the tempo, yes? Hmm? legatom. Es ist vollbracht. This is the word, so es ist vollbracht. This is a tragedy, so now this comes like a phoenix in the old legends, yes? So a phoenix comes out of the ashes, you know, and so out of the everything, he wrote the same time the Missa Solemnis, so it's all connected. Yeah, but you go to the make an arch. Loud.
Save it, yes.
We have a long way to go. One more time. Long. Wonderful organ. Think of the organ, yes? No, it's much better now. So, only crescendo when he writes it, yes?
Yes.
Only there. Yeah? Do one more time, please, the whole. Yes? Thank you. tragedy of it that he breaks down. He cannot, you almost think he has arrived home, yes? And then he breaks down again because of the this struggle with the illness, yeah? So that he keep the pedal, because this half step, this is very, very tragic, yes? Or I just do the end of the first fugue and then into this next section, yes? This is not the right expression, because look what he says there. Perdendo la forza. So this is somebody who can hardly speak. And you are playing something very beautiful, but it's not here, you know. So this is, imagine that you have almost no strength and no air and no, you are at the end of your life, yes? But the left hand is, softer, you know. Don't play the two hands together. Left hand in tempo, right hand very free, and it's not what the norms of aesthetics is. Yeah? Nothing to do with beautiful music. Not beautiful. Too much tone, you know. You haven't. I'm very glad you are very healthy. God should keep you healthy. But this Beethoven at this point is not healthy, you know. So let's. I play the left hand. You play the right hand. Thank you. right, we lost, but now, you know what I am trying to get at. So now you do it yourself. Stay near the key. No choreography. Stay una corda. Stays in una corda, yeah? And how many chords are there, G major chords? Yeah? No, skolka? Skolka raz? No. So count how many chords, it's very, it's 10 chords. 10 chords, because imagine it's 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock morning or night? Night. So the clock strikes 10, and so this is the turning point. Yeah? And so because it's una corda, so this crescendo only comes from pianissimo to mezzo forte. Yeah? But you came up to fortissimo and you got off the soft pedal. You have to keep that, please. Here, please, pianissimo, far away, so good. Still very, very quiet. So you did the phrasing like this. We went to the middle, so also here go to the third bar. This is so medieval, yeah, from ancient times. Čemu tak gromka? Tiha, tiha. Do it one more time. Now it's very good, but you, with the fourth entry, yeah. Here, from here, so phrase, and then I don't hear the augmentation. Yeah? So you have the diminution against the augmentation. Yes. So please, from here. Too loud. Yes. Okay, now it's very good. But the last note, yararam, yararam. You play tirarim, yararam, yararam. Good, but not quite. But you are doing very well because most people play this twice too fast. But you are aware of this problem because Beethoven writes here meno allegro. So actually, it's a notation. So what was an eighth note here will be a 16th note. Yeah. Move. Okay. All right. And here we are a tempo. Okay, play one more time. Yeah. play the right hand once alone, please, slowly. Yes, you see? So you have to go across the string and if you play the violin, yes? So, okay. And here on the modern piano, the left hand can be very heavy. So be careful with the double basses. So one has to hear the violin figuration. Just one more time, please. Yes, the triumph of yes, to overcome his own, you know, tragedy and never give up, never. And it really such a wonderful, very good in these times to play music like this and to listen that there is always hope. Very good. Спасибо вам.
Thank you. Thank you.
Very good. Please play from here, please, observing the rhythm, because you are a little, should be sharper, the dotting, yes? Concentrate on the short note. Ba-bam, ba-bam, ba-bam. The short note with the down bow. So, and we have the equivalent of that on the piano. Okay, now go to the very beginning, please. Now at the very beginning. Also here the short note matters. Pipam, papam, yes? This will not work because you take away your hand and you just hold it with the pedal. With Beethoven, tenuto is tenuto. Pedal, but titim, papa. You hear them, earthquake. Softer, even softer. Very good. No, no, no. Why are you rushing there? Tirim, pam, 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 pam. The tempo is very good, by the way. Because maestoso, but nowhere does he say grave or largo. So you are very right about that. But don't change the tempo there. Sweet and bad. No, but you have to suffer here. For the dissonance, you know the clash of the dissonance, yeah? Mm-hmm. The timpani. Yum, bum, 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 bum. Destiny. Yeah? Oh, one more time. Here. Yeah. You are almost right, because almost 99% of pianists make an accelerando here, which is a big mistake. You don't, but it's not logical. Exactly. And then the semi-quavers will be identical with the, what are they called, hemi-demi-semi-quavers. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Good. All right, so go from the timpani. Those are non-legato. Almost everything is non-legato. But not on the surface, not je perle. And phrase. Dominic is your name.
Yeah?
So observe this fourth Sunday. Ta da 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 da. You know, that serious every time. Espressivo, no?
Yeah.
So it's a little bit soft, slower there. And a tempo, all right? Over articulate, because you think you are playing very clear, but back there it's blurred.
Right, yeah.
Yeah? So think of the people in the back. They also have the right to hear. There is a wedge on each one. Retardando. There is one, but you do it two bars too early.
Right, yeah, yeah.
So here's still in tempo. Now retardando. And also ritardando, but how much, you know? And you get into adagio, but you get into something an adagississississississimo. It's too much, yeah? Just try to get the tempinire. But it's right what you are doing, because this is such a turbulent movement, and this is the oasis, the only one, yeah? Furioso. Symphony, clarinets, flutes, yes, all right. Now, ya da 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 da. I need the dissonant. Those suspensions, yes, more. Hit it, but fight for it. Yeah. Now, when you play this in a concert, I hope you repeat. Yes.
Yeah.
Please.
Yeah.
You wanted to save my time, yes?
Yeah.
Very kind of you. But with Beethoven, repeats are compulsory, especially something like that. All right, now let's go to the development. Very good. No, but misterioso. It's spooky. The main voice here, in your opinion?
Really, it should probably be.
That's right. Yeah. So always start that with the head. Of course, we need all the other subjects too, but this should be number one. Yes, to bite. Yeah, one more time. This fugato, but it's too loud. Piano. No, you are too friendly here. Yum, bum, bum. Not so nice. Not so nice. Rum. Yeah, just go there. Better, so because with the three diminished seventh chords, we have all the 12 tones. Yum pum pee, rum pum pee. Yeah. So and the yum. It's difficult, difficult. Yeah. Don't make it sound easy. Articulate that and the team. You have the heavens and the hell. So this is like the Divine Comedy, Inferno. Yeah. All right. So that's very good. Let's just do the coda, please. Bum, yum, yum. Tired, tired, tired. Play once alone the left hand from there. Phrase. Slower, yes. That's another story, yes. Yes. All together and be careful, it's the pedal is too dirty. Good, good. One, two, three, four, finished. No, not attacca, but it's real, there's no fermata. So this is exactly. One, two, three, four, finished, yeah? I would not continue. No, please, I mean, it needs absolute sure he didn't want this attacca. A little bit of, it's a very exhausting movement. Yeah. All right, so now the tempo of the arietta. What does Beethoven write here?
Adagio, molto semplice cantabile.
No, so the question is, it's adagio molto or adagio molto semplice? I think it's adagio and very simple. So not very slow,
yeah,
but very simple and singing, yes? It's better, but it's not very non è molto semplice, è molto complicato. But beautiful. But now, let's say already when you play the play this. This is very natural, so why don't you play? It's, what is it, in 9/16, yes, that's the meter. So, but it's not 9 beats, but 3 times 9. That's much nearer to now. Now go to the second part. Dolce vita. So. The two hands have to complement each other. Thank you. still here. It always has to keep going, keep moving. Don't stop. So tempo. So just finish the previous variation. A little flat. A little more enthusiasm. Yeah? The dynamics, even if it's not written pianissimo, because it's this part. It says something melancholy, no? Shooting. I only hear this with you, the Sforzandi notes, but also the others, please. Well? Oh. difficult when we go from the thumb to the fifth finger. Or you do the other fingering, same, because I do in one position, but all right, do your fingerings, but this piano, yes, and that needs a little time because I don't hear the subito piano. The first note has to come a little later. Yeah. But this is still forte. Good, but you should never in Beethoven iron out the sforzandi. Yes. No, you don't have to slow down. And the pedal. You know, there are so many pedals in late Beethoven, not here, because listen to the acoustics. This concert hall is like a pedal in a very good way. So you have to use it constructively. Yeah? So then you play in the Royal Festival Hall. Then you are not so lucky. Then you have to play with much more pedal. No? That's right. Not takatatakatatam. Why a new tempo? La 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 la. It's actually the same tempo. Just here. just hear notes. I want to see the stars, starry sky. Yes? Yes. The third note is too long, yes? The texture changes. No. So when it's diatonic or chromatic, it's not the same. And always the pulse, yum, one, two, three, one, two, three, boom. That keeps us going. Tranquillo. This is an important cross section, no? Because actually the variations are finished here. We finished this fourth variation and now comes like a free fantasy, yes? Okay, so, I will use here, I don't like to talk about, but it's, you will understand. If we play this with curved fingers, it produces a different sound. If you flatten the fingers, yes, then you have another surface on the keys. And that would be more appropriate here. Yes. To be more heroic here. recitativo, yes? Mm-hmm. Your left hand little finger, you have to. That's important, that gives the beat. Right. Otherwise, it's just trills. Mm-hmm. Use the time somehow, this extreme, the extremes of the keyboard, yeah? This is the moment that we have been waiting for, yeah? Here we would like to stop the time. Section, it's like a bridge. Thank you. Zarzado, Pavid. Understand the rhythm, yes? This is important. And then you are too fast. Difficult. You see? Very good, but now place this soft but deeper in the key. Not on the surface. Uh-huh. Crescendo. You came a very long way now. Very good, Dominic.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bravo.
Well, there are no words at the end of a class like that. Was really a very, very, very special experience for us. Thank you very, very much for coming to be with us. As you said when we were talking earlier, that Beethoven is relevant always, but perhaps even more so in these times. And I think that's a really important message that our students really will take away from how you've been working with them today. And we really, really appreciate everything that you've given us so generously, your time and your energy and your wisdom. We're really so, so thrilled to have you here and back with us again. Thank you so much. And to all of the students, to thank them, the three students who played. I know that this class will live with them forever. And of course, also for all the students present here today, you'll remember this for the rest of your life. I know you will. I certainly will. And you'll remember in 40 years' time. Ah, yes, do you remember when we were at the college and we listened to the last three Beethoven sonatas and the journey that we were taken through by Sir András. So we've been so lucky to have you here. And I know there's a lot of appreciative people here, so thank you very much.